That's your final lesson. Now for your first meal. Get them behind the knee, boy. They hate that.
Yow!
Down the earlobe. It's tender there.
Yow!
That's my boy.
That's fun, Unc. But he said a bad word.
What's that?
Raid.
Raid?
Yes, Raid, house and garden bug killer. For both indoors and outdoors. Raid hunts bugs down like radar. Sweeps flies and mosquitoes from the air. Attacks roaches and ants as they crawl. And kills them dead. Kills all kinds of bugs indoors. Outdoors, Raid house and garden bug killer wipes out insects that attack your flowering plants. Even protects evergreens. So get Raid. It smells good, but it really kills them dead. Created by Johnson's Wax.
Below in the deep, there's adventure and danger. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
After guiding our friends from the Baron's Cave, the condition of Glowfish is very grave. If they can get him to the pit in time, his health would soon again be fine.
The Glowfish has spent too much time away from deep water. While he was lighting the Baron's Cave for our escape and recovering the magic shellophone, the reduced pressure of the thin water made him collapse. How long do you think he can last, Doc?
Well, a great deal depends on how quickly we can find our way back to the bottomless pit. Whew, we must hurry, Dan.
What's this? A signpost in the sea?
The scout fishes mark trails because it's so easy to get lost here. And there are many dangers all around.
The bottomless pit is just ahead. Come on, Doc.
Hurry, Dan. Oh, I hope we're in time.
Oh, stay alert, Trigger. That Glowfish has foiled us by leading the diver and those fish out of the cave. But we'll get our chance for revenge.
What are we going to do, boy?
I am not sure yet. But it'll be something sinister.
Ooh, that's nice.
Quiet now.
The entrance to the bottomless pit. The Glowfish lives 3/4 of the way down. Blow him away. The pressure will restore him.
I hope so. He saved our lives. Goodbye, Glowfish.
As he goes down, you can see him perking up.
Oops. Careful, Trigger. Why don't you watch where I'm going?
But I don't know where we're going. You hear, boy?
I have another diabolical idea.
Oh, well, boy.
The signpost. Quick, Trigger. Give me a fin. We'll turn the signpost around.
Then the diver will never find his way back. Will I get lost, boy?
It sounds too good to be true. Quiet now. help me push. How's the glowfish, Doc?
Looks brighter already. Very good sign, Dan.
Good.
Now we must get back to Miss Minerva. The others will be worried.
Right. Just a minute, Doc. My ship is signaling me.
What do you mean?
It's a message from the captain of my ship on the surface.
Attention, Diver Dan. Calling Diver Dan. Do you hear me?
Yes, Captain.
Are you all right?
Fine, sir.
Your time is nearly up. You'll have to come back to the ship.
May I have a few minutes more, Captain? There's another area I want to explore.
Very well, Dan. But don't take too long. And be careful. You're in a dangerous area.
Very good, sir. Come on, Doc. I'm anxious to meet Miss Minerva. And we must report that the glowfish is all right.
Well, let's hurry, then. We'll return to the signpost and pick up our trail from there.
Now, keep out of sight, Trigger.
Yeah, boss.
Not boss, Baron Trigger.
Okay, Baron Trigger.
Quiet, you fool. If they come.
Careful there. Ah, there's the signpost.
Oh, yes, we go this way.
We must be careful not to go near the teetering rock. It's very treacherous.
I haven't much time. I hope it's not far to Minerva's palace.
It must be right up ahead.
That was a great idea, boy.
It's working like a charm. It won't be long now.
Minerva's throne is right up ahead. The signs tell Dan and Doc. But Baron's switch leads them instead to perilous, teetering rock.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, flashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. There's adventure and danger. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
Doc and Diver Dan near death are they, as under teetering rock they stray. The rock moves and begins to shift. Could the Baron be the giver of this evil gift?
Look out!
Help!
What happened?
Teetering rock tottered and stopped.
Something kept it from falling.
Look, under the rock.
It's
Ozzy, the oyster.
His hard shell kept the rock from toppling. See if he's injured, Doc.
Ooh, if I could only examine him. Ozzy. Say ah. Oh, dear, he's still embedded in there. This rock tottered and it only teetered before. He could push it back.
Trigger, you spongehead. Why didn't you tell me as he was under there so the rock wouldn't topple?
You didn't ask me, boss. Baron.
I just can't do it.
Whew. Rest a bit. Ozzy doesn't appear to be in pain. Ooh, I hope your pearl's not damaged, Ozzy.
Pearl?
Oh, yes. Ozzy's pearl is as large as a turtle egg. Largest pearl in the seven seas, isn't it, Ozzy?
Mmm. If it's that large, then Ozzy's pearl is the most valuable in the world.
Is everything valuable to you? You told us that Skipper's gold had great value.
He wants it?
Then I want it.
How can we get it?
I'll find a way. Well, I'll give it another try. Apparently, strength isn't the answer. I still can't move Teetering Rock.
Well, it didn't totter on its own. Somebody must have pushed it.
Probably Baron and Trigger.
But if they could do it, why can't you?
I don't know. But I do. I know the secret of Teetering Rock.
Well, I think I had better go for my bag.
And see if you can find Finley.
Finley, Seabiscuit! Oh, Doc, you're safe. Where's Diver Dan?
Oh, he's all right. Oh, but Ozzy the Oyster's caught on the Teetering Rock. Dan can't get him out. I'm going for my bag. Go to Teetering Rock, Finley. Dan needs help. I'm on my way.
I just can't do it.
Dan, oh, Doc told me.
Oh, Finley, Seabiscuit.
Ozzy, are you all right? We'll have you out in a jiffy. Don't worry. We'll get this rock to roll. Let me take a look at this rock. It must be a matter of balance. If we can just find one spot where the rock balances, a little shove should do it. I found it. Watch. See? Nothing to it.
Suffering salamanders. Foiled again.
Well, you can't win them all, boss.
Ah, shut up.
I can't wait to see that pearl.
Why, haven't you ever seen a pearl before?
Of course, but Doc told me that Ozzy's pearl is the largest in the world.
It sure is.
So that makes it the most valuable.
Open up, Ozzy. Show Dan your pearl.
Wow, it is as large as a turtle's egg, just as Doc said. What a beauty.
I see it, boss, I see it!
Quiet, blabbermouth.
He'll hear you.
What was that? I heard something. Sounded like Trigger and the Baron. What'll we do, Dan?
They may be after the pearl, too. Listen, I have a plan. Let's pretend we're going to move on, leaving Ozzy behind. Are you game, fellas?
I'm with you, Dan.
Well, Ozzy, we have to leave you now, but we'll be back in about an hour. Now, don't you get back under Teetering Rock.
That's right, Ozzy. You're supposed to sleep in an oyster bed. So long!
So, hi, Oz. How you doing, chum? Here you got yourself in a stew. An oyster stew. Get it?
Get on with it, you clown. Forget the jokes.
About that pearl. Nice weather, eh? About that pearl. I hear it's a beaut. How about a peek, old buddy? Old buddy boy, yeah? Just a teensy-weensy peek, huh? Come on. I'll bet you don't even have a pearl at all.
Will Baron Barracuda escape with the gem, or will Diver Dan and his friends capture him? The next episode will let you know. So join us again on our very next show.
He moves among creatures of frightening features. flashing, he's flashing, jaws flapping, fin snapping, quad. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. Below in the deep there's adventure and danger. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
Baron Barracuda, with evil stealth, tries to steal a pearl to increase his wealth. The largest pearl that's ever been found could make Dan famous the world around.
Curses! Curses! Get me out!
Look, Diver Dan, do you see what I see?
There's a fish caught in the oyster.
It's the Baron.
Yeah, I'm getting out of here. See you around, boss.
Call me Baron, you traitor.
Sure, Baron, you traitor. See you.
Help, help. Get me out of here.
Diver Dan, you better hold the Baron so he won't get away. This time we've caught him redfin.
I've got him.
Ozzy, it's okay to let go now. Diver Dan has the Baron by the tail.
Caught in the act, you would-be pearl napper.
Too bad the Trigger isn't here.
With this evidence and with the three of us as witnesses, you, Finley, Ozzy, and I, any court will convict him. I think this is the end of the Baron. Seabiscuit, tell Miss Minerva we're bringing in the prisoner.
But I'm innocent. It is all a mistake.
Mistake? Mistake? What were you doing inside the oyster shell with a pearl in your mouth?
I lost my monocle. I thought it was my monocle. That's it, yes.
Tell it to the judge. Your monocle is right where it always is.
So it is. Judge, you say?
Well, everyone, even criminals, are entitled to a fair trial. We'll bring the Baron to justice. One of you can be the judge. I suggest Miss Minerva.
Of course, Miss Minerva. We better take the Baron to her right away.
So I'm going to meet the mermaid at last. Let's go.
Thank you, Ozzy.
Thanks, Ozzy.
Tell us anything. He says the Baron Barracuda has been captured. Finley and Diver Dan are bringing him in for a trial. What's that, Seabiscuit? Diver Dan wants to meet me. Oh, no. Well, I've never met anyone from above. Oh, I wouldn't know how to act.
Oh, he's a very nice fellow, Miss Minerva.
Oh, I'm sure he is. But I just couldn't face him.
What did the Seabiscuit say?
He says that Diver Dan wants to attend the trial.
Well, sure, Miss Minerva. After all, he did help us capture the Baron.
Have you forgotten the rules of King Neptune? Only the folk of the deep can be present at the trial of a fish.
Yes, it's true. For fish only. Well, I'll go out to meet him and explain the rules to Diver Dan. Ahoy, mateys. Hey, be that the Baron you got there?
It sure is, Skipper. We're going to put him on trial for his crimes.
Fine idea. Yep, hang him from the yardarm, I say.
We'll let the court decide that, Skipper. Come along. We may need you to testify.
He can't do it, Finley. A shipmate of mine's coming visiting.
Oh, who's that?
A peculiar-looking cuss, name of Harris. He comes from the Adriatic Sea. You got to get the place ship-shape, you know. You better get along now and keep a sharp eye on that blasted barracuda. Don't let him get away from you, young fella.
Don't worry about that, Skipper. I've got him.
Oh!
Let's go. He's got away.
After him, you lovers!
The Baron, as free as the tide. He escaped from our friends so he couldn't be tried. The fish want to catch him, they pursue in a fury to brain that rascal before their fish jury.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, flashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects them, he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Cameron Swayze for Timex. And since the program is originating in Florida, we thought it would be appropriate if we came to the famous Marine Studios here in Marineland, Florida, where the porpoises are not only playful, but educated as well. Here's their trainer, Andre Cowan. We're glad to have you with us, Andre. And this porpoise is Nellie. Nellie is going to give us a very educational demonstration that will prove that Timex waterproof watches can really stand up to their claims for being completely waterproof and shock resistant. And she is going to do it by taking this Timex waterproof watch right here over the hurdles in every sense of the word. We've affixed this Timex waterproof to this baton. Now, Andre, will you place the baton in Nellie's mouth? And then Nellie will go over the hurdles. We'll see two really remarkable demonstrations, one by Nellie, one by Timex. A 300-pound porpoise going over three 3-foot hurdles. There's the first one. Remember that Timex takes the full brunt of the blow each time. And now she'll turn around and come back. And here she comes. One. Two. Three. And let's see how that Timex took the torture test. Thank you, Andre. Let me move over here, ladies and gentlemen, so you can get a good close-up and see what I have just seen. That this Timex waterproof is still ticking perfectly. Truly an incredible demonstration.
But Timex, with its exclusive V-conic movement, takes such a licking and keeps on ticking. Remember, a Timex waterproof always says waterproof, either on the dial or on the back of the case. Timex is also anti-magnetic and has an unbreakable mainspring, yet costs as little as $9.95. For the youngsters, there is the smaller Timex Sportster. It, too, is waterproof and shock-resistant and priced for as little as $9.95. Timex makes the perfect graduation gift. Another reason why more people buy and give Timex than any other watch in the world.
Below in the deep there's adventure and danger. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
The wily fish, the Baron, has given Dan the slip. He's being chased round about and all through Skipper's ship. It seems that they will catch him. They certainly shall try. but he just might elude them. That Baron's very sly.
He's escaped for good now. What's so funny, Skipper? The Baron's escape is no laughing matter.
Who says he's escaped?
Well, you just saw him go down that funnel.
He didn't get very far, Finney.
What do you mean, Skipper?
That funnel is mighty tricky, laddie. It narrows down to just a tiny hole. The minnow couldn't get through the other end. Come along and see.
You won't get away this time.
Curses, curses, curses!
Poor diver, Dan. Will he ever meet Miss Minerva now? Seems like the perfect opportunity.
Doc, what are you doing here? Didn't you know we're bringing the Baron in for a trial?
Yes, but Dan, you are not bringing him in, I'm afraid.
What do you mean?
The rules of Neptune forbid anyone who is not a fish from attending a trial of one of us.
Oh, I see. Well, of course, I'll abide by your rules. I'd better tie up the Baron for you. He's a tricky customer.
Tie him tight, Dan. Better put an extra knot in for luck.
There. That should hold him. Finley, I'd better hold the pearl for you until you've delivered the Baron. When you need it as evidence, I'll be waiting right here.
Right, Dan. I'm sorry about our rules.
Yes, so am I.
Here's Finley now.
We have that Baron. Here he is, mean as ever.
I'll report you all to King Neptune. It's a plot, underhanded and underwater.
Baron Barracuda, King Neptune is well aware of your wicked ways. And you know if you show your face at his court, you'll be arrested on the spot.
Look at the crowd.
Ugh, me scalp them. Let's kill all them.
Everyone wants to see the Baron get what's coming to him.
Now, quiet down, everybody. We must be sensible and fair about this. We don't want any mob hysteria. There's always an answer within the law. He must have a trial.
That's just what Diver Dan said.
And we have lots of evidence, too. The shellophone, for one thing. We'll show it all at the trial.
Diver Dan is holding the best evidence of all. The pearl.
The pearl?
The pearl!
Pearl.
It's Ozzy's pearl. Say, Minerva, did you know Diver Dan thinks the pearl is valuable? He'd like to take it to the captain. He's holding it for us now.
Since he's been so kind to us, go to Diver Dan and tell him he may show the pearl to his captain.
Well, I'll go right now. But, oh, my.
What is it, Finley?
Oh, I just thought of something.
What?
We're in a predicament.
Well, how's that?
Well, Diver Dan must show the pearl to his captain, right?
That's right.
If he takes the pearl up to the captain will keep it, right?
That's right.
Well, if the captain has the pearl, we won't have the most important evidence for the Baron's trial.
Oh, dear.
And if he leaves the pearl here, then the captain will insist that he go back to the ship and they will all sail away.
But the diver can take another pearl or any other valuable object. All the captain wants is something of value. Well, that's why he sent Diver Dan down here.
He can have my stethoscope.
I give him deep sea wampum.
Bless you all. You are all so kind. Most important thing right now is to put the wicked Baron on trial.
Let's not waste any time.
Well, I'll round up a jury. But first, Miss Minerva, you should go over the rest of the evidence in the chest while I get the pearl from Diver Dan.
You will all regret this.
But the boss is in real trouble. Yeah, I gotta do something here. If only I could stop that creep Finley from coming back with the pearl.
Dan, I've come back with a pearl. We're going to need it as evidence.
Finley, I don't know what to do. I've been thinking it's my duty to show this pearl to the captain. After all, I was sent down here to find anything of value.
You mean you won't let us have it? We need it to convict the Baron.
You know I wouldn't do a thing like that. Look, I'll give you the pearl to use as evidence. As soon as the trial is over, rush it back to me so that I can take it up to the ship. Uh-oh, too late.
What's wrong?
It's the signal. The captain wants me right now. What'll I do? This is the evidence you need to put the Baron in jail. Still, if I don't bring up the pearl, the captain may get discouraged and sail away. I'll never see you folks again.
To go up with the pearl or leave it behind, on this matter, Dan must make up his mind. What will Dan's decision be? Tune in again, and you will see.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, flashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. There's adventure and danger, that's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
A pearl, a trial, a decision to make. Now Dan knows which way to take. Join us now in the cool green sea, and you'll discover what Dan's decision will be.
It's a hard decision to make, Finley. I want to help you prosecute the Baron, and this pearl would be perfect evidence. But I also have my duty to my captain. I should give him the pearl.
It's a decision you'll have to make yourself, Diver Dan. And whatever it is, I know it'll be the right one.
I've made up my mind, Finley.
What is it, Dan?
Take the pearl. Use it for the trial.
Yippee! Now the Baron's really hooked. But what will you tell the captain?
Well, I don't know. Say, I could tell him that there are some interesting developments down here that look promising. That would be the truth. Take the pearl, and I'll come back to hear the results.
See you soon, Diver Dan.
Goodbye, Finley.
Like they have the boss dead to rights.
Now, why can't I spring him? I guess I'm as stupid as the boss says I am.
Here's the pearl, Miss Minerva.
Wonderful, Finley. The jury is selected and everyone is ready for the trial.
Should be the prosecutor.
Oh, it'll be a pleasure, Doc.
But who will represent the Baron? He is entitled to a defense, you know.
I'll represent myself. I'll show you all that the great Baron Barracuda cannot be defeated by a group of minnow brains.
If you insist, Baron, you may represent yourself. Finley, place the Baron where everyone can see him.
Hey, poor boss. He's sunk, that's for sure.
Curses. You'll all pay for this. I'll fry you in your own oil.
I'm worried about Goldie. She may not be able to testify. The Baron frightens her.
Now, Goldie. He can't hurt you. Well, now. Let the court come to order. Does the jury understand that it is to be impartial and that the facts must be studied carefully?
Guilty.
No. This will never do. I said we must be impartial. We must keep an open mind.
I got an open mind. Let's drop him in a bottomless pit.
If only there was someone here who wasn't familiar with the case.
Well, I know of someone, Minerva.
You do?
Yes. Skipper Kipper has a visitor arriving. Somebody called Horace from the Adriatic Sea. He'll be coming here with old Skip.
Good. We'll make Horace the final judge. You see, Baron, how fair I want to be with you. We're bringing in someone who's a stranger to this case.
Ah! I need no favors from you. If I weren't bound like this, I'd eat you all up.
Oh, you wicked fish. You frightened Goldie again. Don't be afraid, dear. I won't let the Baron hurt you. Here, I'll put you over here where you can't see him.
Ah! Now I can get even with these creepy fish for what they're doing to the boss.
Now, as I was saying, that's Goldie. Trigger has Goldie. Well, he's getting away.
Stop him, someone.
All is not lost. Not yet. Now you will have to release me if you want your precious goldfish back. I knew I'd find some use for Trigger someday.
Kidnap the tiny goldfish, thus obeying the evil wish to hold her as hostage for the Baron's release, that they again may plot their wealth to increase.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, slashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the wing. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. That he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
Minerva is despondent. She's brokenhearted. Trigger has taken Goldie and then departed. Can Dan stop Trigger and save Goldie too? Stay tuned to this channel and the answer you'll view.
As you go, Trigger.
Uh-oh, who needs you?
There, there, Goldie. Calm down now. You're safe. Well, how can I get you back to your friends? Well, here comes Skipper. And who's that with him?
You-hoo!
Oh, I mean, oh, blame me if he ain't that diving feller. Come to the trial, eh? Yeah, hello there, little Goldie.
No, I'm not allowed to attend. Will you take Goldie back with you, Skipper?
We'll be glad you may.
Say, who's your friend, Skip? I don't think I've seen him before. In fact, I've never seen a fish quite like him before.
I'm pleased to meet you. I'm Harris.
Harris is an old shipmate of mine. Say, come to think of it, I've never seen a fish like Harris before myself. Just what kind of a fish are you, Harris?
Gee, I don't know. Just a clean-cut, average, everyday fish.
I'd like to take a picture of you, Horace. The captain would probably be interested in someone like you. Do you mind?
I'm flattered. Here, this is my best side.
Got it. Say, you'd better be swimming along. The trial's going on right now. Take good care of Goldie.
Look, Goldie's back. Skipper must have rescued her.
Nope, it weren't me. Like that diver fella. Folks, want you all to meet my friend Horace. He's spending vacation with me.
Hello?
Horace, would you be willing to serve as a judge in our trial of the Baron Barracuda? We want an impartial judge, and you are the only one who is not aware of the things the Baron has done. Will you be our judge?
Certainly. I guess. Anything to oblige, I think.
Good. We shall proceed. Finley?
Baron Barracuda, you are charged with, among other things, trying to steal Skipper's gold, stealing Minerva's shellophone, the attempted theft of Ozzy's pearl, and in addition, we accuse you of endangering Goldie's life. Doc, will you help Goldie to the stand? Goldie, did the Baron try to smash your glass bowl?
It must have been my twin. I am a law-abiding citizen. Furthermore, I am noted for my donations to widows and orphans charities.
Yeah, you made them widows and orphans.
Baron, you are on trial. Will you speak only when asked?
Miss Minerva, will you hold up the next exhibit?
Yeah, that's the key to my ship.
Did you not take this key from the ship of Skipper Kipper when you deliberately and with malice aforethought slammed the door on Dan's lifeline, hoping to kill him?
I never saw it before.
He's lying. See the scratch on his monocle? He got that from the key when it turned it.
Now, Doc, if you'll help Goldie back to her place, we'll call Ozzy to the stand.
Goldie, you were fine. I'm proud of you.
Here is the pearl we all know belongs to Ozzy. Finley, all you must do is establish that the Baron stole it.
Did this Baron try to steal your pearl, Ozzy?
Keep him away from me.
Well, the answer is obvious. The Baron's tooth marks are on the pearl.
Baron, since you are acting in your own defense, do you wish to say anything at this point?
I'm glad you asked me that question. I shall heretofore and now in this case proceed to explain to you fine fish of the viny deep that by following the footprints of an unknown hand in the sands of the future, we shall inevitably resort to the cataclysmic and unfounded cycle of the party of second part.
Baron is just trying to confuse the court with his double talk. We've heard the facts. Now, Horace must decide if the Baron is guilty. Well, Horace, what is the verdict?
Mm-hmm.
And so we see swimming before us an important fish with the name of Horace. What will the verdict of Horace be? Tune in next time, and you shall see.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, flashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan.
Constipation can be a problem for anyone. And when constipation occurs, it's interesting to see just what doctors consider important about a laxative they might use or recommend. Well, a majority of the doctors we heard from said they wanted a laxative that is effective, gentle, close to natural acting. A medicine that can be used with complete confidence. Now, X-Lax has been used with complete confidence by many doctors and millions of people over the years because pleasant-tasting chocolate and X-Lax is effective. Overnight, it helps you toward your normal regularity. X-Lax is so gentle, so close to natural acting, there's no upset, no discomfort. So whenever your normal regularity is interrupted, you can rely on X-Lax, the laxative that helps you toward your normal regularity, gently, overnight. X-Lax.
Satisfying, got the pleasure. A coffee break makes the moment bright. Fresh aroma,
friendly flavor.
Make it coffee, make it often, make it bright.
To brighten any moment,
make it coffee.
To enjoy that fresh aroma,
make it often.
Make it up fresh each time in a clean container. And for full flavor,
make it right.
And here's how. For each cup of fresh drawn water, use one approved measure of your favorite coffee. That's all, one approved measure per cup.
Satisfying cups of pleasure.
A coffee break makes the moment bright. Fresh aroma,
friendly flavor.
Make it coffee.
The Baron shows his evil smile as we await the outcome of the trial. Now, Horace the judge must make his decree. Should the Baron be jailed or should he go free?
You think the great Baron Barracuda can be provoked by this nonsense? I shall remember all of this and all of you. Revenge will be sweet.
Baron, you have done many evil things. But your greatest crime was frightening helpless little Goldie.
Well, he will not frighten her anymore. Now, if he only had the Baron's henchfish trigger.
We'll get him in time. Right now, let's take care of the Baron. Has Horace reached a verdict?
Here he is now. What will the verdict be?
Miss Minerva, I have reached a verdict.
Yes?
Yes?
Yes? Yeah.
I find the defendant, Baron Barracuda, guilty.
Hurrah!
Hey!
Oh, boy!
Great! Oh!
wonderful.
Yeah, I'm proud of you, matey.
It was nothing, really. I saw my duty, and as a public-spirited fish, I did it.
Now, Finley, you can give the pearl to Diver Dan to show his captain.
Why don't you present it to him, Minerva? Now that the trial is over, Dan can come here and meet you.
No. Take the pearl to him and give him this as a token of my gratitude for all that he has done for us.
Anything you say, Miss Minerva. I'll be back soon.
Yeah, Harris and I'll come with you, Finley.
Diver Dan may just follow Finley back here to see me. I'll leave right now. Oh, but first, let us decide what to do with the Baron. He should be put in jail.
I'll build a jail for him.
Me help him, you. Finley, what was the verdict?
The Baron's been found guilty. They're putting him in jail, Dan.
And Miss Minerva says you can have the pearl now.
She also wants to give you this. It's a shell necklace as a gift for all you've done for us.
That's very kind of her. I wish I could meet her. Oh, Finley, about the pearl. You can give it back to Ozzie.
You mean the captain doesn't want it?
I never had a chance to tell him about it. Do you remember the picture I took of Horace?
I hope I didn't break your camera.
Well, here it is.
Gee, looks just like you, Horace.
Makes me look a bit fat, don't you think?
The important thing is, the captain took one look at the picture and really got excited.
Why?
Horace is an extinct fish.
I'm not extinct. I'm Horace.
Sure don't look extinct to me. Solid as a coral reef, this one.
What is all this extinct business anyway?
And he's right here.
What is all this extinct business about?
When I took this picture up to the ship, and it was developed and processed, our scientist on board took a good look at it.
Yes, and?
Yeah, tell me too.
Our scientist is Dr. Emil Harpoon, whose specialty is prehistoric ichthyology.
Come again?
He's a famous authority on fish of long ago, and he says that this fish was thought to have been extinct, to have disappeared. No fish such as this has been seen for hundreds of years.
I've been down here all the time.
Since Horace is such a rare species, he's worth more to the scientific world than any gold or pearls.
I smell something fishy.
We'll let Diver Dan explain, Horace.
I've been assigned to find this fish and to take him to the ship so that we can take him to an aquarium for all the world to see. So,
now the problem is, will Horace go along with you or not?
You'll be famous, Horace.
Oh, my. First a judge, and next minute a celebrity.
You better take your time thinking it over, matey.
And say, while you're thinking it over, aren't you afraid the Baron might escape again? Perhaps we should get over there right now.
Well, don't worry about the Baron. The Sea Scout is keeping a sharp eye on him.
Alone? Just the Sea Scout?
Oh, afraid so.
Hey, only that dopey Sea Scout on guard. Now's my chance. While they're gabbing about Harvard, maybe I can rescue the boy.
Hey, what have you decided, matey? You gonna go up with this diving feller? It's your decision. This is a free ocean, you know.
Decisions, decisions. I never faced so many decisions in all my life.
Once again, Horace must make up his mind. Should he go up with Dan or remain behind? It's a problem for Horace and for Diver Dan, too. If Horace says no, what will Dan do?
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, slashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he stays his friends under the wave. That's where you'll find Diver Dan.
The wind is deep, there's adventure and danger. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
More precious by far than pearls and gold, the divers found a fish of old. To take it home would bring fame to his ship. But can Dan convince Horace to make the trip?
Think of me as a friend, Horace.
Oh, I'm thinking, but so much has been happening, I'm confused. With the Baron and all that?
Yes, we should do one thing at a time. Let's make sure the Baron is in jail before we think about anything else. He's so crafty, until he's safely behind bars, we're not safe. Better swim over there and check up.
Get along him now. Move him. How dare you? You can't do this to me. I am an honest citizen. And me, Crabapple. Now, move. Get him there.
Locked up tight, I see.
Good and tight him. Him never get out of there.
Let's inspect the place.
Never get out of here, indeed. I trust the associate will see that I am not long in this place. Right, Trigger? Right, what? Call me Baron Nitwit. Right, Baron Nitwit? Don't worry. Nobody ever get him out. Me stand him guard.
Oh, good. Well, I must get back and tell the others. Now we can concentrate on Horace's problem. To go or not to go, that's his problem.
Go with you. Maybe he wouldn't even like it up there.
Oh, he'd like it. He won't have any work to do, and people will come from miles around to see him.
Yeah, and maybe laugh at him.
Well, folks, the Baron is behind bars with a scout fish himself watching him.
Well, now we can get on with Horace. I say the landlubbers who come to see Horace in the aquarium will laugh at him because he's different.
No, they won't laugh. He'll be a rare marvel. The center of attraction. Something special.
Well, he's something special here, too. He's our friend.
Now that it's finally safe for decent fish around here, it seems a shame for him to leave.
Yes, and how safe is it up there with all those people? Maybe someone will steal Horace out of the aquarium. Are all the human barons in jail?
No, they're not. But no one, no bad people can get Horace. He will be guarded night and day.
Just like the Baron?
Well, Horace might as well be in prison, too.
I do like it here. I can come and go as I please.
If you come along, you'll be doing a great service for humanity.
Humanity? What has humanity ever done for him? At least down here, there's only one Baron.
Quickly.
It's up to you. It is your decision.
I just don't know. I want to do the right thing.
Well, don't be so wishy-washy, Horace. Just say you won't go and be done with it.
I am unusual. I mean, I'm not like other fish. I'm the only one of me there is.
You're a fish. A fish is a fish. What else?
Well, Skip is right. And a fish belongs with his fish friends, not somewhere in a bowl with a lot of people gaping at him.
Maybe it's my duty to go. When I die, no one will ever see a fish like me again. Maybe I should show the world how I look.
That's right. You should.
He should.
You would be proud of me, perhaps.
Hey, you wouldn't live long up there, matey. A change of water would be harmful. It always is.
Why did it have to happen?
We'll have to stay and help now.
What can we do?
I'll pledge my help again.
Once more, the wicked Baron is free. Again, he threatens the fish of the sea. His head is full of crafty schemes. Our friends are in danger, or so it seems.
He moves among creatures of frightening features, flashing teeth, slashing jaws, flapping fins, snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. That's where you'll find Diver Dan. The sights that he sees are surprising and stranger than ever you'll see on the land.
The Baron has escaped from jail and thereby hangs today's fish tale. Dan and Finley are on his trail. Can they capture the Baron, or will they fail?
Did you find any clues, Finley? Anything to tell us where the Baron went?
Well, there's nothing here, Dan. Only a cage.
Empty.
Well, how did this happen? I close him gate like this. Then I go round him back and check him like this.
Yes?
Then I go him over here, take him up post in military manner him, and I fall him asleep.
He's more slippery than a greased eel, that one.
Let's see now. If we could get a strong cage, strong but light. Say, we have one aboard ship. I'll have the captain send it down. Of course, I can tell him it's to capture the Baron.
What will you tell him, Dan?
Let's see. I could say I need the cage to trap Horace.
What was that?
I said to trap Horace.
Trap Horace? That's me.
But what would the captain want with Horace?
Well, don't forget Horace is a rare prehistoric fish. He'd be worth a lot to the captain.
Oh, why couldn't I be an ordinary little sardine or something? I'm getting out of here.
With that excuse, the captain will give me a cage.
And we'll use it to nab the Baron.
If we knew where he was right now.
How good it is to be free in the open water again, eh, Prigger?
Yeah, you just ain't whistling Santa Lucia, boss.
I am not whistling anything, and call me Baron Blubberhead.
Okay, Baron Blubberhead.
Careful. Get behind these rocks. Someone is coming.
I've got to get away. Far, far away.
It's that miserable excuse for a judge who found me guilty. Get him, Trigger.
He's as good as got, boss. I'll make fish cake out of them.
Now my revenge begins.
Oh, why did I ever leave the Adriatic Sea? First Diver Dan wants to trap me because I'm such a rare fish. Now you want to make fish cakes out of me. Well, I'll be a rare fish cake.
Let me at him, boss.
Just a moment. What was that you said?
I said, let me at him, boss.
Not you, Aldrich Bait. Him. What did you say about the diver wanting to trap you?
Everybody's against me. I'm the poorest of poor fish. Diver Dan said I'm a rare prehistoric fish, and he's going to put me in a cage and give me his captain, and now you want to make a fish cake out of me.
Trigger, you fool, let him go.
Oh, you poor little fellow. You have been treated badly by your friends.
Huh?
Be quiet. Pretend we are his friend.
His friend?
Be still, you sound like a motorboat.
You see, dear Horace? This proves you cannot even trust your friends.
That's right. And we're your friends, so you can't trust us.
Trigger, you idiot.
Come over here, stupid.
I am glad.
There is a method to my madness.
Yeah? It looks more like there's a madness in your method, boss.
Clown. I want to win Horace over to our side.
What for, boss?
Don't you see? Here is a perfect opportunity to get rid of that meddling diver once and for all. Since he wants Horace, we'll kidnap him and hold Horace for ransom.
Hey, boss. We could ask for that pearl.
Excellent, excellent. So you are not dumber than a rock after all.
Hey, I'm as smart as any rock I know.
Let us get back to Horace before he overhears us. Our dear Horace, let us become good friends.
Well, I don't know. Nathan, you were a thief.
Lies, lies, all lies.
Horace, my friend, let us forget that recent misunderstanding. It was a miscarriage of justice, and certainly you are not responsible.
It was that unspeakable diver who made trouble for me, the same diver who wants to trap you.
Horace, I propose an alliance. This may do the trick. We'll catch the Baron if all goes well. Then once he's in the cage, I'll tug this rope, and that will be the captain's signal to hoist away. And we'll never see that barracuda again.
You mean this rope here?
Don't touch it, Finley. The captain might think that's the signal to haul up the cage. Now to look for the Baron.
A trap is baited. A trap is set. It's intended for the Baron. But whom will they get?
He moves among creatures of frightening features. Flashing teeth, slashing jaws, flapping and snapping claws. He protects and he saves his friends under the waves. That's where you'll find Diver Dan.